Welcome to another edition of our live Pittsburgh Sports Line TV show in the BP TV studios. I'm Al Levine, the talking machine. And if they pan the camera to my left, there is nobody else with me. Chip Hayner got tied up at work. Smoking Jim Frazier, I have not heard from him. He may be missing in action. I'll try to talk a little bit and see what we can come up with. I have some promos first. First off, I want to thank all of you for watching us on Comcast 7 only in Bethel Park. Thanks for the great feedback and people coming up see your show and watch your show every week. Appreciate that. And then thanks for everybody watching us here in Bethel Park, also on Verizon 32 and all the way out to Nemacolin, Cranberry, Wexford, and every point in between. We appreciate all of you. And I can't thank you enough for watching us for the 6 years and the growing fan base that we have out there. It's appreciated. Facebook hit a brand new high. I'm very proud of this. 6,554 likes. So thanks for watching all our 400 plus TV shows. Plus, we post a lot of stuff on there and glad you like our page. I do have some promos. You know, we start out strong with our sponsor for Tuesday night. Olive Oils Pizzeria, right at Hillcrest Shopping Center. Just had a great steak hoagie, great pizza. So their food's all fresh, freshly made. Give them a call there, 412-831-1900. That's our sponsor for Pittsburgh Sportsline every Tuesday night. And thank you again, Olive Oils Pizzeria. I'd show you another slice, but I finished it. I'm done with that. Now I got another historical Bethel Park Historical Society's Schoolhouse Arts and History Center. 107 new windows are in there. Thanks to the Metropolitan Window Company. They had a different small business event there this past Saturday. Hope it went well. You can donate as little as a dollar to this 501c3. Check it out. Pittsburgh History and Landmarks Foundation. It's a designated historic landmark. It's the trolley on South Park Road. Check it out. We always end our shows with Stay Joey Strong. Poor Joey didn't make it to his ninth birthday. The Joey Fabus Childhood Cancer Foundation is a 501c3. They donate all of their money to the doctors to research and find a cure for DIPG, which is a dreaded brain cancer that this took little Joey's life and takes hundreds of kids each year. It's a death sentence. They get diagnosed with it. There's no cure. 1 year, they're dead. It's terrible. All right, Dave Cable likes to have some fun at my expense. I don't mind. Uncle Al wants you to help at BP TV. Like today, we got Devin Shea in control room. We got Steve, Rookie of the Year, Fisher, and we got Ethan in there helping out. You could be one of the volunteers that helps run the cameras, soundboard, and Devin Shea does it from A to Z. So check it out. I want you for BP TV, 412-831-3304. Give Dable a call. Dave Cable a call. Now, I'm with a trustee on the Bethel Park Community Foundation, and it's bpcf.org, and you can get an application there for from $100 to $5,000. If you do different things in our community, you can get money for that to help your group in Bethel Park. Again, that's BPCF, Bethel Park Community Foundation. Check it out online. And maybe you could get some money for your group to help do good things in Bethel Park. Well, that's the promos I have for you. I have one more thing I'd like to promote. This beginning of the show is sponsored by Skeets Lewandowski's Skeets Service Station. Right down the road past Trax Farm in Mineral Beach. Give them a call, 724-348-4715. Tell Skeets you heard from the talking machine that he can work on anything that runs on gas. And believe me, I've seen it. They even have a forge in there. He's making knives and other tools. So they've expanded, and just great things that they do. He's an honest mechanic, and it's not that far away from our studio, less than 7 miles away. Check out Skeets Service Station. Well, this is all I have for the beginning of the show. When we come back, if Smokin' Jim's with us, we'll do some fiction and fact from Smokin' Jim. If not, we'll handle my on location, and we'll just wing it with the show. Somehow the talking machine will keep on talking. Don't change that dial. Chief, if you're eating, have a good dessert on me.
Hi, I'm paramedic Jim Corns with Tri-Community South EMS. Here to talk to you today about our 2017 annual subscription drive. When you have a medical emergency, you count on your community's emergency medical service to be there for you. To guarantee services available, Tri-Community South EMS counts on you for financial support through our yearly subscription drive. Without your support, we cannot provide emergency medical care to our residents. Tri-Community South receives no tax revenue from the three communities we serve. Your tax dollars do not fund Tri-Community South, and emergency service is not free. You may like to think you're never going to need EMS, and we hope that you never will. If you do, we want to guarantee that we will be there for you, as long as we are still in service to respond. Without your support, you won't have that assurance. You might think, it can't happen here. Yes, it can, and you don't have to look very far to find multiple communities that have lost their EMS service due to lack of financial support. Tri-Community South Subscription Drive is going on now, and every year less residents have shown support through our subscription drive or donation. If you haven't subscribed, we hope that you will consider it. Please help keep your EMS service by your subscription of $60 per year. Remember, EMS is not free, and most insurance companies do not reimburse 100%. Currently, out of approximately 27,000 households in the three communities, only 18% have shown their support by subscribing. Every household will receive a subscription in the mail by the end of January. You can also subscribe online at www.tcsems.org. Please, show your support through a subscription. Thank you in advance, and stay safe.
I got late breaking news. Please pan to my left. Smokin' Jim Frazier is in the house. I have no idea what even happened to him, but he's here. And we'll be talking to him shortly. First, I got to do our on location. We will be on December 11th. That's a Monday, second Monday of the month. Olive Oils Pizzeria and more in Brookline Boulevard, 930 Brookline Boulevard. Lined up a couple guests. I'm working on a couple more guests. Smokin' Jim and I may have a few more, but got a couple good guests coming up for this Monday. And then I got a special guest. I've never interviewed Santa Claus on Pittsburgh Sportsline. Frank Funera. Maybe I have, but I'm going to be interviewing Santa Claus and Brookline on the 11th. So we'll have a good show there. $5 large pizzas, $5 hoagies all day long when there's Pittsburgh Sports Line. Just tell them about it and you'll get it. So come on out, watch the show live. We tape it for 1 hour from 7:30 to 8:30. We're honored to be doing a show in Brookline with Frank and Olive Oils Pizzeria and more. I'm just happy we are and able to bring great guests to you. And thanks for the great feedback on all of our guests that we have on our shows. It's nice hearing from all of you out in the public. And I can't thank you more than enough, especially Smokin' Jim Frazier. We hit a brand new high of 6,554 likes. That's the most likes we've ever had on Pittsburgh Sportsline. So that's always nice. And then that's what I got for on location. Still looking for a couple other spots. Maybe come January, we'll announce a different location or two, so stay tuned. I keep putting feelers out there, and we'll see what comes back. We're going to go to something special on our show. I created Fiction and Fact for Smokin' Jim's Almanac. Let's hear that next.
Thanks, Al Levine, the talking machine.
Where's the video? What happened?
Sorry, I was running a little bit late.
Well, was there traffic in Monroeville?
You know what? It's
just don't tell me you weren't in Monroeville.
This was a CP holiday.
This is off the record because I don't like to bring up race. I don't know what he does. Well, welcome to the show, Smokin' Jim Frazier.
Hey, thank you, sir. And I was trying to study up on Pocahontas all day today. That threw me a little bit late, but I'll.
She's even on a coin.
I didn't know that. I'm finding out.
You know,
more
she
and
was
more.
With. She helped Lewis and Clark. You don't even know Lewis and Clark.
No.
Thomas Jefferson. This is some history, folks. Sorry, okay. My man. Graduated with so many degrees, General Suddies, General Sue. Who knows what he got from Cal U? I can't figure it out. But Lewis and Clark were hired by Thomas Jefferson to explore the Louisiana Purchase and all the land out west.
Okay.
So they did that. They took off from Pittsburgh.
Really?
In boats and, yeah, filled up all their, they had a big crew with them. They ended up meeting Pocahontas out there.
No, Thomas Jefferson was president, right?
Yeah, yeah. This is going back in history.
So Thomas Jefferson,
early 1800s.
Early 1800s.
Thomas Jefferson.
He hired Lewis and Clark.
Clark.
Okay, and they took and for what?
To explore and report on the land.
And they took
west of the Mississippi.
And they took Pocahontas with
yeah.
them.
Yeah.
And she was Indian, right?
Yeah.
Okay, and she stayed with them after she got back.
Well, I don't really know.
Oh, okay.
You have to find out.
All right, because the funny thing is, I just found out today, President Trump, he honored some Indians today. I guess they, I don't know what for, but I guess they were important in the war for communications purposes. And you always talk about me. You know,
that doesn't even make sense.
Well, you're always talking about me giving credit to Babe Ruth when we were standing under his photo.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah, that's true. Because he was not a pirate fan.
So President,
how does this?
So yes. President Trump.
I can't wait to hear this one.
President Trump is honoring two Indians under President Jackson's portrait.
You're kidding. Andrew Jackson.
Andrew Jackson.
Do they know he chased out more Indians than anybody?
And I heard,
he treated them terribly.
He said the only good Indian is a dead Indian.
Wow.
So if you pull that up on YouTube, you'll see that. But
so you and Andy Jackson are similar.
We're similar, man. So you can't get on me. You can't get on me because President
I
Trump.
I get on anybody that misspeaks like that.
Well, President Trump did the same thing, basically, that I did. So. But
well, Andy Jackson actually had a nice side where he adopted an Indian child and took care of him.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, he had a lot of problems with the Indians back then because they hated him. They called him savages. So he was in a lot of wars and killing
now, who
Indians.
Now, who was called savages? He called them or they called him?
Both.
Both. Wow. I got you.
They
know
didn't
what?
Get
I may,
along. This American history is new.
I may read
folks,
my first book.
Folks. Hate to interrupt you. This is a sports talk show. We're supposed to have some fiction and fact from Smokin' Jim's Almanac, but he can talk whatever's on his mind if he wants since he come in here late and segue into fiction and fact because I don't know what he prepared. I see no notes today except President Trump honored two Indians.
That's it. Well,
in front of Andrew Jackson's photo.
Well, I'll combine them both real quick since our main
No, you can take
man,
your time. It's just me and you.
Okay. Since
we have time.
Since our main man Chipper is off. But to give a little credit for what's on my mind is for the Pittsburgh Sportsline Team of the Week has to go to Washington High School.
Why?
Excuse me. Because they blew out Steel Valley in a double-A championship game. I've been sick and tired of hearing about Steel Valley for the last 2 years.
I thought you'd been picking them.
Yeah, I picked them because You know, they were one of the favorites, but I did say that Washington would beat them in the championship, and it came
true. We
got to
pull the tape up on
yeah,
that.
I got the printout. Now, I was happy to see that. So, Washington, I think they won 37-10. It was a blowout.
Wow, that is a blowout.
And I think they spotted them on the first touchdown. So, I was happy to hear that. I was at the Monte Christian Academy.
You're kidding. They got beat.
Jeanette game. They got beat. They went for two. They have no kicker. So, next year, look for a Monte Christian Academy to bring in a white field goal kicker so they can find. They have not kicked the extra point,
folks,
or field goal all year.
I know we started the show late, but Smoking Jim kept his reputation of bringing the race card out almost instantaneously.
Maybe the first white male student in the Monte Christian history to kick next year. But what a great game. Jeanette beat them 35-34.
I know.
The second half, Monte Christian Academy, they were down at halftime. And so the second half, they decided to go with Pittsburgh Sportsline Karma and start our guy, Israel Reed.
Get on.
And he put on the show, man. He threw for 118 yards, two touchdowns.
Get on.
He ran for 75 yards.
Where was his dad at?
His dad was, you could hear him in the stands. He had two-point conversion touchdown receptions, and he had six tackles on defense all in one half. So congratulations to Izzy Reed for an outstanding job.
Go another, Izzy, baby.
Another friend of the show, R.J. Hart, had seven receptions for 105 yards and a touchdown in the losing effort. But the head coach of Jeanette, I played college football with
your kid.
Roy Hall.
What year was that?
Yeah, it was back in the day, and he was
when you're getting your general studies.
Yeah, and these Jeanette guys were real tough back then. They had a reputation, especially the Hall. There was a ton of Hall brothers, and him and his twin brother actually came.
Get on.
And the funny part was, and I'll just go into fiction and facts with this, is we had a great tight end named Gary Bureau, who is he was an All-American tight end. He and Terry O'Shea, probably the two greatest tight ends in Cal history. O'Shea ended up going to the Steelers. But B-Row was probably even better than Terry O'Shea, who was a great player. And but B-Row was an arrogant, cocky cat and lived in the weight room.
Aren't you allowed to be when you have success?
Yeah, I guess so. And he lived in the weight room, and he picked with a lot of underclassmen. And,
sort of sounds like Greg Lloyd.
Yeah, a little bit, a white Greg Lloyd. And so
I had to throw that
exactly,
out.
Exactly, man, without the
it sounded
t-shirts.
Sounded familiar.
And the funny part was now Gary Bureau works for, he's an undercover guy for the federal government. So people only knowingly seen him one time. Now, he could be in here because he's always in disguise. So anybody
just sit in the corner there.
That's it. Anybody that we played with actually only seen him one time. He came in disguise to a alumni football game and played in the game and then got right back in disguise and disappeared. So who knows where he is. He's serving the country for a number of years if he's still alive. But anyhow, he's picking with Roy Hall. And he didn't know that Roy Hall was a three-time WPIAL wrestling champion and a state wrestling champion and was recruited all over the country to wrestle, but he just wanted to play football, even though they didn't last at KLU that long, his twin brother. But they couldn't wait to get back to Jeanette. And he put a beat down on Gary Bureau, man. It took everything we had to pull him off, and at that time I didn't believe in breaking up fights, so I just let it go. As team captain, what else would I do? But this freshman,
well, you didn't want to get hurt in there.
This freshman put a beat down on Gary Bureau, and later we found out that he was a three-time WPIL wrestling champion,
a little late,
and a state wrestling champion. But a double fiction and fact with Smoking Jim's Almanac, since we got a little time, is I wanted to honor a Lily White team, Quaker Valley, who I predicted would beat Aliquippa, and they did 2-0. And I tell you what, Quaker Valley reminds me of a team nobody ever talks about. And that was my state championship team when I was at Gateway. And I tell you what, it reminded me so much because you had, the team I played on was all white. And we only gave up 32 points the whole year. And I seen the same similarities. Here you got these rich kids.
You said Swickley's coming on strong.
And they're going to be, we got to get out there. We're going to get them on the show, Al Levine, the talking machine. But I look for Swickley to dominate and be a powerhouse like Gateway is and some of these other powerhouses like Pine Ridgeland and stuff like that.
You heard it first, folks. Here's Smoking Jim going out on a limb again.
But the reason I like this team so much is they play defense the way you play it. You know, and I always say that where's the white cornerbacks?
Yeah,
reverse
yeah.
Reverse discrimination. Right. And the team that I played on had 2 white cornerbacks. And they're playing against all these fast brothers that can run like a deer and slam dunk a basketball. And they never gave up a touchdown all year long, and they never gave up.
Did they have names?
In some games, they didn't even give up a completion. And then we had our coach was so funny. That's the only difference is you're never going to get a coach like Pete Adamarino, who was a hands-on coach. We had a tight end who was a valedictorian. He was 4.0 student.
Wow.
And he was a great, great athlete, man, had quick feet. He lived in the weight room. And I remember Coach Adam Marino yelled at him one time and says, I wish you were stupider and had better hands. This guy could not catch a cold butt naked in the rain. But when we ran a lot of sweeps in those days, he was so valuable at that tight end position because he always hooked that defensive end or he always hooked that linebacker and he was outstanding, but he couldn't catch, you know. But everybody played their role, and that's where I see with Quaker Valley, to hold a great Aliquippa team, to shut them out at Heinz Field. And I looked at these guys and I was like, man, it brings back memories because when you play on a team like that, you really don't notice how great the other players are because your defense is so disciplined and so good that you look at other guys and you say, well, wow, they're talking about this guy being great. He got, 15 carries for 12 yards against us. But then later on, you see him against other teams maybe on film or when they go to college. And you say, wow, he was really good, but he couldn't get nothing on us. And that's Quaker Valley. If this team doesn't win states, there's going to be teams behind them that will win year after year after year after
really?
Year. And I'm going to be part of it because I met a beautiful young lady who has kids coming up in the system. And she looks like a supermodel. We've been texting back and forth on Facebook. Her kids are wrestling now. So look for me to show up as Swickley.
Hey, Smoking Jim, as a little side note, on Facebook, Smoking Jim puts up a new photo with a woman every time. Well, today somebody asked, with all these photos, are you getting any dates?
Did you see that? That was funny.
My tea out on that one.
That was a good one.
That was the best line I've seen yet. So here's Smoking Jim. We don't know if he's getting any dates, but he's working on texting.
And that was a minister
that said that.
So
you got people in high places,
brother.
High
places, man. People, curiosity killed the cat, I guess.
Well, you're providing the curiosity because each day you put up a new photo. Some of you repeat with the women, but I don't say anything, and guys keep thinking they're a different one each day, but there's some repeats out there.
Some are worth the repeat.
I knew you'd come back with that. I just want to know what their reaction is to that.
Well, you know what? It's really a blessing and an honor, Al Levine, the talking machine, because I know when I was really seriously involved with somebody real serious, I would take offense to somebody if I see somebody with a profile picture.
I understand that you'd be outraged. Yeah,
and I'd be knocking on their back door, but it's been a blessing. I've been on
Facebook's a little different for you.
Well, it's a little different for me, but I tell you what, it's just a gift because people trust me. They believe in me. I've been on vacation with married women, staying in the same hotel room, answering the phone when they're in the shower. That's their husband or their fiance. And I ask them, do you want them to call you back? And they says, oh, no, they're with you smoking, Jim. They can just call in the morning. So people just trust me with their prized possession.
This is the inside edition of Smoking Jim Frazier.
I'm honored for that. So
I thought you were just honored to take a picture with them.
Yeah.
I didn't know we'd get to the next level with just answering the phone while they're in the shower.
Yeah.
Well, folks.
Business trips.
Folks, he got so many business partners, and he got 99 godchildren, so I can't figure it out whether they're truly related or what the heck's going on. But these business partners, ever since I've known him for 6 years, he's gone through about maybe about 7-8 business partners, and they're all women. And with that happy note, we're going to come back to some Steeler talk on the next segment.
Yay!
Hi, Bethel Park. Remember me? My name is Jason Planetzer. I was the host of a little show here. You may have seen it. It was called the Jason Planetzer Show.
What would you say your experience at BPTV, how has that had an impact on your life?
I found my voice. I learned how to be funny. I learned how to create things. I learned how to collaborate with people here. I developed an interest in film and comedy and making videos. It stuck with me. It continued through my life. I got into working on motion pictures. I now I'll produce small videos. I'll work with producers on commercials, television projects, feature films. I scout locations on TV shows and movies, which involves me reading scripts, finding the locations that need to be shot, and collaborating with the director and production designer to find the perfect spot. It all started at BPTV for me.
Have to make a correction when we have an error. I said Pocahontas. Well, she had married John Smith with the first community in Jamestown. Sacagawea is on your dollar. She helped Lewis and Clark. So I stand corrected. The Indians, Skip Atkins mentioned the two Indians were the Indian code talkers during World War II, that nobody could break the Indian code. So they were able to have secrets and all that stuff on the airwaves and all across the battles during World War II with the Indian talkers. So, Smoking Jim, there's a little fiction and fact from Al Levine's Almanac with an assist from Skip Atkins.
Thanks, Skip. Hall of Fame Skip Atkins.
A Hall of Famer. We appreciate that.
I like to learn.
Well, we want to feature the Steelers. I'm watching a game. Unbelievable how I tell you each week I bleed black and gold. But I don't live or die with the Steelers. They play down to the level of the competition, and then sometimes they win. guess what? They won with a couple seconds to go. It was a great game. For some unknown reason, Big Ben was throwing passes that people could catch. They weren't over their heads. Antonio Brown made the greatest catch of his career.
My goodness.
He looked from when the pass was thrown that he was out of bounds. He dragged his foot for over 3 foot and caught the ball, made one of his greatest catches before the field goal. So it was quite the pass, quite the catch. My hat goes off to Antonio Brown.
You think Sammy Coates could have made that catch?
Who? Who? Vance McDonald can't make that catch. You were telling me how he catches the ball, and I said, no, he drops the ball.
Yes,
no, he can't even play because he drops the ball too much. But he did save a touchdown in a game, so I give him credit for that. He didn't quit, just can't catch. Reminds me of a story you told
my
about
tight end.
Your
my
tight end.
That might be my high school tight end.
They're incognito. These guys can block, but they can't catch. But, yeah, the Steeler game was very exciting. They had all the B's, including Boswell, except he missed an extra point. How do you miss an extra point? And he kicked a 53-yard field goal to the open end of the Heinz Field, which is rare.
That's a record by the
Heinz
Field. Yeah,
that was a record.
Wow.
So shocking that one of the B's, Boswell, got that. And that could have gone about 63 yards.
Wow.
The way he kicked it deep.
Wow.
So you just never know. You can't count them out. Steelers are looking sharp at 9-2. Unbelievable, and everybody's afraid of New England. Even Tomlin was talking New England. Him and Tony Dungy were talking about New England, and he was saying, yeah, it'll probably be us in New England. When do you ever hear a coach
never
talk three games ahead of time
never
that it could be New England in them? So that was refreshing, and it shows that he knows that people listen to him and others, so he just put the word out. Because it's going to be New England and Pittsburgh. They'll be playing December 17th. Put your money on Pittsburgh at home.
Wow. Wow.
I don't care what Smoking Jim does. He's been losing these houses left and right. Who knows what he did with 14 points in Green Bay. Hopefully, he picked Green Bay. That's what I hope. What's your thoughts on the Steeler game, buddy?
It's funny. You know, everybody knows this is the favorite show that I do, but I do other shows, and I did a show on Channel 11, and I said that
Championship Chase.
And I said on that show, don't be surprised if this much maligned quarterback, Brett Huntley, passed for 400 yards against the Pittsburgh Steelers. This is a guy who makes a lot of bad decisions.
He's a rookie.
One of the bad decisions that he made was coming out of UCLA after his junior year thinking he'd be a first-round draft choice. So that's a bad decision.
Well, he's had 3 years on the bench behind Aaron Rodgers.
Yeah, yes, it.
Look what it taught him.
And the second bad decision that he makes is he chews gum instead of wearing a mouthpiece. That's another bad decision. But he got a gum for an arm. He broke all of Troy Aikman's records at UCLA. And he also is an underrated runner. I don't know why he doesn't run. He stopped running a lot at UCLA, but he ran for over 1,800 yards at UCLA.
I don't think he likes getting hit in the pros.
Yeah, and he ran for 30 touchdowns, and he got 4.5 speed. So I think that the game that he played against the Pittsburgh Steelers, I think, will get him another contract deal with another team next year.
Really?
Probably, because he's beginning to prove himself now, and he's getting in his rhythm a little bit, and I think a couple more good games. But they had the Pittsburgh Steelers on the ropes. They played well. I thought that Coach McCarthy made some bad coaching decisions down the stretch because I thought when they got
the ball back.
How
about that field goal kick of 57 yards?
Are you crazy?
You know where you're at,
yeah,
Heinz Field.
And he's from Pittsburgh.
I know, Greenfield.
Yeah, how in the world do you make that kind of decision, giving the Steelers a good field position, then you get the ball back late in the game on that last drive, just run the clock out and go to overtime.
Yeah.
But I'm a type person, you know, I won a lot of money this weekend, not only on Green Bay, but on Auburn. I knew that Auburn would beat Alabama's because I don't look at your record, I look at your warts. And if you look at the Pittsburgh Steelers' warts, like I said all along, I put a post up on Facebook that Penn State could beat Alabama. I think that Auburn proved me right.
I don't know. But
if you look at the Pittsburgh Steelers' warts, it's the same.
You're a little crazy with your logic.
It's the same warts that the Steelers had last year, in that they cannot stop the pass.
Were you reading the dictionary and you saw warts?
Yeah, there you go. Did I mispronounce it?
No, no.
Okay.
No, because I don't know where you pulled warts out. I figured something
I think it means blemishes. I look at your blemishes. But
It can be a blemish.
But last year, the Steelers couldn't stop the pass.
Yeah.
And the first half of the season, nobody tried to throw on them because you had backup quarterbacks and you had bad football teams. Now you're starting to play better, a little bit better passing teams and slightly better quarterbacks. And the Pittsburgh Steelers are getting ripped in their secondary last 3 weeks. So you're 9-2, just like Alabama was undefeated, blowing everybody out. But I looked at
their... Hold it. I thought all these bad quarterbacks that we were beating meant the defense is great this year.
Yeah, that's what you would think if you go with the sports writers and the coaches in this town, and the team is
and
just
talk
so arrogant.
Radio, sports talk radio.
Yeah, I mean, you're a 14-point favorite. You kick a walk-off field goal to beat Green Bay, and you're walking around like you really did something. This is a team that didn't have Clay Matthews.
They do play down to the level.
Exactly.
Of teams, like I
exactly.
talk about all the time, and sometimes they win. You know,
yeah.
Teams with losing records, I think we're like 7-14.
Wow.
So that's 14
wow.
losses.
Wow.
Since 2012.
And they got a tough one this week, the Red Rifle.
I don't even want to get into that. Monday Night Football.
Monday Night Football. We got to stay up.
Wow.
We got to stay up, man. No.
Prime
early
time for the Steelers.
No early morning tea report on the Tuesday.
It'll come out. It comes out. Today we put a late one up. I had a couple things to take care of, but it's up. You have to like that today.
But, the players seem like they get in a big feud with Burfict, who's a great, great player. But you won't hear nothing this week. Everybody's tough when they ain't got it. You got to go to Cincinnati. Let's hear all this wolf tickets you're selling with Burfict, because Burfict don't mind getting a fine. He don't mind getting suspended. So
he's proved it.
Yeah,
he's proved that he'll hit you illegally. Legally, it doesn't matter to him. No, he should be thrown out of the game because you shouldn't be pushing the edge like that. Just like look at the two players that just got suspended for one of the dumbest things ever in a fight.
They can't fight, can they?
No. And what do you care? You're grabbing a chain. What are you wearing a chain out in the field for?
Yeah.
You tape it to your chest this time. And he still ripped it off.
At least he didn't pull out his earrings. They'd wear that too out there.
Well, he couldn't get to it right away. He didn't like that bling.
Then the brother's out there fighting with no helmet on, man. You got to be nuts.
Hold on. You played football your whole life. Would you take your helmet off and then throw punches?
Never. Never.
No, that's ridiculous. Then a two-game suspension for these two because they carried on 2 years in a row.
Well, the one good thing is you can look for it to end, because both the guys I found out is from Dallas. And I found out from another guy who lives in Dallas named Primetime Deion Sanders. And Deion says he's going to call them both and tell them enough is enough. So when Primetime gives you a call...
That's like you telling the folks, bet the house on the Red Rifle next Monday night. If you don't bet, don't start. Bet the house on the Red Rifle, because Cincinnati will beat the Steelers. Smoking Jim Frazier in advance.
But hey, not to transition off the Steelers,
but to
stay with Heinz Field. Congratulations to the Pitt Panthers, huh? Upsetting Miami in the
number two
in the turnover chain, man.
Yeah. And how about Narduzzi predicting at halftime that we would win?
Did he?
Yeah, they interviewed him off the field, you know, like they do, and he said we're going to win this game.
Wow!
So he made the prediction, and the players backed him up.
That's good.
He was only up 10-7.
They had a chain too in their locker room, man. The team, but I tell you what, that freshman quarterback Pickett looked real good.
Well, he was supposed to be good, but they screwed up his eligibility.
Yeah.
They put him in a game.
For one play.
What was that about?
Yeah, the starting quarterback was out that game. They had a black quarterback. I guess they didn't want to play a quarterback, even though he was playing special teams. And then you had DiNucci, who
I knew we'd get the true scoop.
His helmet came off. So in college football, if your helmet comes off, you got to go off for one play. And so instead of putting the black quarterback in,
why did they just go Wildcat?
Yeah, Wildcat. I mean, he is a quarterback. You go take the red shirt off the freshman. So maybe it was a bad decision, but turned out right.
It was a bad decision for the kid.
Yeah.
He's a good quarterback.
Yeah.
And he showed what he's made out of running for that last touchdown.
Yeah.
That was unbelievable.
So he's going to start next year. I feel bad for DiNucci because I said, and the one thing I don't like to do, L. Levine, the talking machine, I don't like to do what-ifs because there's no win. You know, if somebody, I like to make a evaluation on how a guy's going to do at the next level. But I don't want to have a what-if because a what-if is never right. So if I was advising DiNucci, I would advise him to go to UPenn, University of Pennsylvania, who he had already committed to.
Wow.
To play quarterback and get a great education because some people think...
Why not go to Delaware like Flacco?
Well, that's true, but this is coming out of high school.
I mean, now.
Yeah, now that would be good.
That's Flacco was at Pitt, and he said, see you later. You won't play me? I'm going.
Yeah, well, they wanted to, move him to tight end.
I know. He went to Delaware, and look what he did.
Yeah, sometimes you got to transfer.
He parlayed his great season during the Super Bowl.
Yeah.
Saw all the stats. Four good games. Four good playoff games.
Yeah.
Hasn't done anything since. How about his ratings under, like, 38?
Is it that low now?
It's so low, 34 point something.
He got his money, though, didn't he?
He got his money 5 years ago.
Yeah.
Can't hit anybody.
Well,
looks bad out there.
Well, I predicted they would never win again without Ray Lewis. Ray Lewis is just such a great leader.
They just won.
And they...
They just won again.
Won anything significant. You know, there's a reason why he's the only statue out in front of the stadium, so...
They didn't put any other ones up yet. Suggs will get one. He looks bigger than ever and still can play.
Woo.
Does he look big?
If he didn't have money, he'd never get a girl. That's a hard-looking brother there, man. But he could always play Arizona State everywhere he went. And he played. Guess who broke some of his...
I have no
his
idea.
College, well, he broke... What's the little guy for...
White cornerback?
Defensive end, linebacker for New England... That's who Suggs broke his record, sack record, and then a guy named Burfict broke Suggs' sack record college. And Burfict got in so much trouble that he went from being the first round draft pick to seventh round. You know, he's one of the last guys picked. And he's still doing the same thing, but like I said, he's doing everything he's doing is about the same as James Harrison did. So the Pittsburgh Steelers fans would love him if he played in Pittsburgh.
I don't know about that. He's gone a little outside the rules.
Well, the one, how can he barely bump the referee? He wasn't trying to bump the referee.
After he's already done it for hundreds of thousands of dollars.
How can he see that little short referee, man?
Come on,
perfect
man.
Tall.
When you see a referee, you stop.
He didn't see him.
He saw him. He's not blind either. Who cares? His reputation got him the penalties. That's what counts.
Got him booted out, man.
Yeah, why not? He was happy about it. He was celebrating.
Do you still really think that was a cheap shot he put on Antonio Brown when he knocked him out?
Definitely.
He wasn't no diva that day.
He was unconscious.
But that was a good hit. I mean, bang, bang. Why don't bang, bang?
Maybe in 1975.
I'm going to have to put that up on my Facebook page. You know I love a knockout.
Nah, this is a whole different era of football. It's a kinder, gentler game.
Hey, you didn't see Devontae Adams going over the middle against the Steelers, did you? Nah. Everything was outside,
yeah,
man.
As well it should
From the
be.
Hash mark out. after he got knocked out.
Well, those things happen.
Yeah.
It's a tough football
game. It changes
game.
Your game.
Well, you actually hear and see the footsteps. You know that. These guys choke up a little bit. It knocks them for a loop there. Come on, man. That's part of what happens. No, but it's some exciting football. The Steelers' record's 9-2. Could have been 11-0 with the two teams they lost to. Shocking. Big Ben's throwing the ball. He's starting to come into his own again.
Another 5 years.
He has his talent. Years. He's not talking retirement right now, is he?
No, he's not.
It's funny how he operates.
Yeah.
No family, no talk of anything.
He gave him a little Pocahontas on the side, I'm sure.
No way, Smoking Jim. The Rooney stopped him on that. He got a wife and three kids now. Now you're exaggerating. You're around that Steeler locker room.
Every Wednesday.
He's got kid photos and all this stuff, dogs, everything. He's a family man. No bike, no nothing. And he's throwing the ball to people, so that's what I like. When you throw that ball down where they can catch it, makes a big difference, right?
That's true.
Definitely. I don't know. We didn't miss Marcus Gilbert, did we?
No.
Didn't even notice he wasn't playing.
Steelers might be missing that $60 million or paying him. Him in one player game, Tuitt.
Hold it. Tuitt looked good on a few plays.
He does about one play a game.
It was more than that this week because I was counting. I think it was two.
Yeah, one got called back. Huh?
I think it was two for Tuitt. He is a big man.
He's 6'7".
Yeah.
And we seen him in person.
I know.
How big he is.
I know. Yeah. He can handle it.
Yeah.
And he seems healthy right now.
Yeah, he's gone Godzilla in uniform, but he's built like Tarzan and plays like Jane.
I know. I figured I'd let you get that out. Come on, Smoking Jim. He's revived. That defense is revived.
How about pump fake Artie Burns? All you got to do is pump fake Artie Burns.
Terrible.
Sometimes you even got to do that. Nah. Sometimes he just runs to the middle of the field, just leaves a guy open deep
all
third.
All the quarterback does is look, and he's gone.
He's fast, though.
Meanwhile, talking about fast, Shazier is unbelievable, the speed he has.
Oh, my goodness.
Just think if he were an outside linebacker.
Yes.
Because he's getting into some traffic there.
Yeah.
He's in on so many plays, it's remarkable.
And even though I had to give credit where credit's due on my Facebook page.
What happened?
Even though he didn't play a very good game, I'm up here tugging at this microphone. I didn't know what was on me. But
Really?
I want to thank Devin Shea for hooking me up again. And Rookie of the Year, Steve back there, and Ethan is back
there.
You
didn't even see them?
Yeah, I seen them all in the hallway.
Oh, okay. You come so late.
But I got to give credit as credit is due. Like I said, I'm in the Steeler locker room every Wednesday, and the most arrogant guy on the team, who if he was laying down on the ground, I'd step over him and keep on going, is 98 Vince Williams. But I got to give credit due. He was playing up until last night or whenever the game was, he was playing like a Pro Bowler. He had over 60 tackles and 6 sacks. From the middle linebacker position, he's not getting any credit. Like I said, I would never interview him. I usually interview the guys that stand next to him. One week it was Anthony Ciccolo. And, you know, I just walk right by.
How's that
get
working
out the
out?
Way, Vince Williams. So I would never interview him.
You can't do that for that paper you work for.
No,
they're not putting that interview in.
Yeah, that's true.
You can tell other folks.
Anthony Ciccolo got a face for TV, man.
And Matakavich, they're not putting Matakavich in your paper.
I love my dirty red. But yeah. this is for the TV show on Channel 11.
Championship Chase?
Yeah, we have those interviews on there.
I'm proud of you.
Yeah, so I get a chance to get my white brothers a little love.
How about Cam?
TV.
How about Cam, some of his
what
plays?
A great play, man.
The and way then, he's moving and hitting people.
Yeah, he got to go to the Pro Bowl. He's got about 9 sacks, something
Why
like that.
Why is he in the Pro Bowl?
Yeah, he got to be Pro Bowl this year. For some reason, they just don't like him. There's something about him that
he got a big head.
Yeah, just like his daddy. He got a big head, but he's missing something media-wise, because he's a very disruptive player since he's been here.
Yeah.
And he's getting up in age, and they never vote him to the Pro Bowl, but I think they have to this year.
You think?
I think they would have to. How can you not?
Your man Watt had a good play.
Yeah, he got his sack. I love it. And he's a hustler. He's a hustler.
He doesn't stop. He's sort of not doing what he was doing the first few games. Because, I mean, he was in your Hall of Fame. I don't know if he slipped out of it.
No, he's still going to go down in history as the greatest linebacker in Pittsburgh Steelers history. But
what a crown that is. That's heavy to carry, that crown.
Yeah, but I think that, you know, he's not getting coached up. You know, Joey Porter can't coach. But
he goes on his knees and runs around.
Yeah, he goes on his knees. He does the one chip challenge and all this kind of stuff.
Yeah.
And he was a great player, but he can't coach. And I think that the Steelers are doing the team a disjustice. Is that the word?
Disservice.
There it is.
I'll help you out. You're out of the dictionary.
Thank you, man. I got Pocahontas on my mind. But they're doing him a disservice by not dressing, by lying and saying that James Harrison's hurt. I'm in the locker room every Wednesday. There's nothing wrong with James Harrison. He spends $1,000, like you said, he spends $1,000 a day on his body. He's still
healthy.
Lifting on YouTube, but they won't dress him. And there's offensive linemen that, because Dupree's not getting the job done over there on the left tackle. All the talent he has at left outside linebacker, he's not getting the job done sack-wise. Watt's not getting the job done. And there's guys on that offensive line that Harrison can just bull rush straight over.
Well, they're saving him for New England in the end of the season.
Well, let's hope.
No,
they're
doing
something.
That's their strategy. I mean, Keith Butler's your man. He don't want to show all his cards.
Yeah, there you go. You know, he got to cover his lips for as a defensive coordinator to call in the plays.
Well, you don't want him to read what play you're calling out there.
It might help.
And this technology.
It might help the defense, yeah.
Not with what he does.
Yeah.
They're just lucky on some of it. They have some younger talent with speed.
Yeah.
Which makes a difference. So
yeah. So it's an exciting time to be a Pittsburgh Steelers fan. And like I said, dude, this is just a cocky group from the coach on down. Anytime you come on national TV and you basically say you're looking past everybody but New England.
Two other games.
Yeah.
Division foes.
And then he's looking forward to who gets home field advantage.
Right.
There's five more games left. He's already talking about the game with New England.
Well,
just
well
tied
he
home
reads
field
the
advantage.
Paper, too. When you see you're tied with New England 9-2.
Yeah.
Who cares if Brady's 40 years old? He still looks great.
Yes, he does.
He's lighting them up again.
He is. And Coach Tomlin is the only coach I know that has so little to do during the game that he's out there sometimes in the middle of the field watching the game on the Jumbotron almost getting ran over by
well,
the
that
players.
Was history. Now he moves away.
Yeah, he's doing this for a catch for Brown.
Yeah. Well, somebody got to cheer him up. Cheer
Crash
these guys up.
He's a cheerleader.
Hey, look at Bell. What did he have, 11 catches?
That's amazing.
Most he's ever had.
That's amazing.
Imagine that. And there's Bell talking about he deserves more money.
Did he?
Well, he's been saying. He's a second leading receiver. You got the best receiver in the league on our team.
Mm-hmm.
You got Bell's the second best. And he's running.
Yep.
Did you see some of his runs?
Man, that one step cut he got, nobody can, and he just loses you.
How about when they're passing out in the field, 3-4 yards out, and he's running for 15, 20 yards?
Yeah, that's great.
How do you beat that?
You can. Sometimes he can hurdle you. Thing I didn't like was they put James Conner in the game for one play and give him the ball. You know, I mean, it's just a waste. There's enough. Now that you're running the no-huddle offense, you're increasing the number of plays.
Hold it, but Haley doesn't get to call those plays.
That, which is great.
That's a problem.
That's why they're doing better.
That's why Ben's ball come down.
Yeah.
It's not going over their heads. He's calling these plays, and he's like, I'll get the ball to you. And you know he can get the ball too. You got to put a little mustard on it. So and Brown came through. Great catches.
Well, what you think? What's your prediction on how long Ben will play? I say 5 more years.
I think he can do another 3 to 5.
I mean, will he though?
Yeah.
Okay. Good.
Yeah, because he's been a drama queen. Yeah, he puts it out there. He gets them stirred up, just like he's a stat man. Only you can't throw those stats when you're throwing the high ball. So that sort of messed him up a little bit. But
I think this week or next week he goes past John Elway.
That's not bad.
For his sixth or fifth all time.
When you put the years in and you've got the stats, they keep adding up.
Yeah.
It's funny how that happens.
Do you think he'll ever go down as the greatest of all time?
No.
Big Ben? Top five?
Yeah, he could be top five.
Top five.
Yeah. But he got to win against bad teams. He got to win against Brady. Is he doing that?
It's hard for him to win on the road. His mind. His
the same
mind.
With Tomlin.
Yeah.
They're together on that.
I wasn't sure if it was the last show I was on that. Did I tell you guys I was with the playmaker, Michael Irvin?
No.
Oh, I didn't say that, but you know me. Nothing's off the record with me. It was the
win. You tell them it's off the record, but then you blatant.
No, I don't even tell them. I ain't hush hush with me, dog.
I know that.
I'll put it out
there. Except what show you're on, Channel 11, yeah, Championship
yeah,
Chase.
Yeah. So it's the Wednesday before the Steelers play Thursday night.
Yeah.
And the Playmakers in town for
for
the NFL Network. And he's sharp, man. He's suited down. He got the alligator skin shoes on. He got the earrings. He got an overcoat. And he got a 23-year-old honey that looks so good. And I went up
there. Oh, that reminds me of you.
Yeah, that's it. And I told him, I'm like, I don't want your autograph. I want her autograph.
What did he say?
He just started laughing, man. We had a good long talk, man, before he took her back to the hotel.
What did you actually talk about?
Oh, man, we talked about everything from Deion Sanders to his days at Miami to some of the stories that didn't nobody know but me when he stabbed one of his offensive linemen in the neck with hair-cutting scissors. Yeah, still playing the game, you know. So, but he actually apologized. He got in trouble with a woman a few months ago and apologized to his wife that he straightened up, but evidently he hasn't. But nobody could say no to this girl that he was with.
Really?
Yeah, I don't blame him. Nobody could say no. So hopefully his wife ain't listening or she won't catch it.
Did you get her name?
You know what? Man, I wanted to. I was hoping. I've never seen her before. I'm not sure if she's from Pittsburgh. You know, she might have drove in from Cleveland or one of the surrounding areas, but I'm telling you, Playmaker told me he'd probably be back a couple more times this year. So I told him there's a couple places I wanted to take him. And but I tell you what, man, whew, she was, I couldn't stop thinking about
her. I can't believe I didn't see a new photo of you with a new sweetie for Jimmy.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm looking for the sweeties for Jimmy. You're disappointing your fans.
Oh, my goodness. She was awesome. Ella being the taco machine.
Hey, and I know how you find these business partners. So I believe you. We're just about out of time. Hope you enjoyed the show. We diverted away a little bit. Sometimes I get Smoking Jim talking. You never know what's coming out next. Just don't bet the house. Who do you like, the Bengals or the Steelers?
The Red Rifle.
I'm going Steelers. I'll take those Steelers all day long. Big Ben is back. And you got the Brown and Bell, and you got Boswell, all the Bs. Hey, thanks for watching our show. And please stay Joey Strong.